y'all I was gonna bump like this. Y'all didn't think that I could bump like this. Said I told y'all I was gonna bump like this. Turn around and I make it jump like this. You wanna keep that party, make it jump like this. Gonna think that I could make it bump like this. See, I told y'all I was gonna jump like this. How you not gonna know it when it hit like this?
Hey everybody, you're now watching Mitri TV. All first-time viewers, please, I want y'all to crank that subscribe button. I think it's up there or somewhere, whatever. But make sure you subscribe, share, and comment, and all that good stuff. And I'm going to start the show. Okay, so let's talk about Bad Girls Club. First off, I want to start by saying Oxygen, whoever's running this whole show, I'm going to need y'all to step y'all game up and, you know, get your stuff together because I had to wait 2 weeks to... Y'all like my ring? Okay, yeah, I had to wait 2 weeks to watch this new episode, and y'all know me, I need my weekly fix of reality TV, especially Bad Girls Club, and waiting 2 weeks, that's, you know, just not cool, that's unacceptable. So yeah, I just love the freaking fact that nobody wants to come into this common room when I'm making until I start to want to make a video. This one back here, he's the devil child. Martavius, get out. Okay, so last season on Bad Girls Club, a few of the girls go out and they go to the club and they leave Christina behind on purpose. So Christina, being the bad girl that she is, you know, she's not going to let that ruin her night. She goes out to the club by herself. And who does she meet there? None other than Natalie Bananaface from season 4 last year on Bad Girls Club. Child, when I saw her, I got so excited. I was like, it's about to be some drama. It's about to be some drama because, you know, I thought she was going to come back to the house and live with everybody and stir things up a little bit, but clearly that's not the case, so I was a little let down by that. This episode opens up with they're all sleeping, and then Christina's alarm clock wakes everybody up, and da-da-da-da, all this crazy stuff happens, and then Leah decides to get up and break Christina's alarm clock. I don't know why. Okay, I could kind of see why she did it, because if I'm trying to sleep, like, and somebody else's alarm clock is going off, that would be kind of annoying, but... You didn't have to go that far and break her alarm clock. But then again, this is the Bad Girls Club. I guess she felt she had the balls to do that. So, hey, what can I do? Okay, so after all that happens, Christina and the other black... What is the other black girl's name? Like, I don't even think... She just, like, so falls into the background, but who cares? The show must go on. So, if y'all remember from last episode, while they was throwing all the liquids and the bleach on each other, the mattresses got dirty. So, while Christina and the black girl was out, Leah and Kristen, back at the mansion, the dynamic duo, decide to do some mischief and switch the mattresses again so that Christina would have the dirty ones. Boy, I'll tell you, these girls are just so freaking ruthless. Like, I don't even know why I watch this show, but I gotta watch because it's so freaking good. So Christina's girlfriend, Lauren, her girlfriend of 6 months, comes to visit her at the mansion, and she's drunk. Now, everybody that knows Demetrius knows how I feel about a little Jesus juice from time to time. But, girl, this is my thing. This is your first time on television, your debut on TV, broadcasting across the whole country, maybe even the world, I do not know. And you decide to get drunk? Really? Like, I don't know about y'all, but if it was me, I'd be up all up in the camera talking about some bam, 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 trying to get me some, you know, some movie roles or some commercial spots, anything that's going to get me them coins, you know? But like, girl... Have some couth with a side of common sense. Like, she wasn't even, like, classy drunk, whatever that means. Like, what I mean when I say that, like, she couldn't even pass for sober. Like, you knew she was drunk. She was just sloppy all over the place, couldn't walk straight. Her girlfriend talking to her, and she talking about some, oh, look at the lizard on the wall. Now, I see why you looking at the lizard, because your girlfriend kind of does look like Kermit the Frog. Okay? No shade, I'm just saying. A pretty Kermit the Frog. A pretty Kermit the Frog. No shade. But, yeah, girl, just use your noggin. Did y'all know that Lauren got a tattoo of Christina's name, like, right on the side of her body? Like, first of all, they only been going out for 6 months. And when it comes to me, I don't care if I've been going with somebody for 6 years. Unless I know I got the money to get that junk removed, I'm not getting nobody's name tattooed nowhere on my body. I don't care if it's tattooed on my ass. I don't care. It's not no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's not getting done. A sidebar, BT Dubs. When they did the little pop-up of Lauren's face, did anybody see Ellen DeGeneres for like 2.5 seconds? Just an observation. So now all of a sudden, Kristen and Leah, the dynamic duo, and the people that say they run the house are all of a sudden trying to be buddy-buddy, chum-chum, pal friends with Christina, which is really baffling my mind, and I'm not getting at this point because just the other day, y'all were throwing all these liquids and stuff on her face and on her bed, calling her Kermit the Frog, trying to get her to leave the house, trying to make her feel like she wasn't nothing. Now all of a sudden, y'all want to be friends. Like, I'm really not getting it right now. And I'm also not buying into the whole, well, you know, we have to be friends with her because, you know, you can't hate somebody that's so nice and I really think she has a great personality. No. Y'all two tried to break her down and y'all realized and y'all looked at each other and was like, listen, this hoe is not breaking and she's not buckling under pressure. And like they say, if you can't beat them, you just got to join them. And y'all are joining her right now. Y'all playing her game. Y'all playing in her court and y'all playing by her rules. Basically what she did, she just played y'all. She won y'all over and she made y'all be on her side. If y'all don't see that by now, you're as dull as a box of rocks. A real true bad girl is not only bad physically, but she got the brain. She has the wit. She has the mentality. She has the mental capability to do things, and she's tough. And like I always say, I'm not trying to stereotype nobody, but she's from New York, and I think she's the baddest one there, just because she's from New York. Just like Tanisha was the baddest one in the house from her season, and she was from New York, I think Christina is the baddest girl in her season, just because she's from New York. And on top of that, I just think the whole relationship is plastic anyway. Like, as soon as they get into some kind of argument, they're going to be back to calling Christina Kermit the Frog and pouring stuff on her face and on her bed again. So, I mean, I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. That relationship right there is plastic. This is something that I wanted to address before, but I'm addressing it now. I noticed that when they were talking on the show, the word dick wasn't bleeped. Like, since when was it okay to just say dick all willy-nilly all over regular TV? Like, it's not even like it's an adult network. It's a regular show. It's on Oxygen. And, like, don't they understand we got virgin ears out here? I mean, come on. What's the deal? Have some cool. But, I mean, pretty soon they're just going to be saying everything, like the F word and the S word, and it's just going to be a wreck, and I'm just so through with it. Towards the end of the episode, after they all decide to go out and come back to the mansion, Brandy Firecracker decides to throw another tantrum. Yawn. I mean, what else is new? That's all this girl does is throw tantrums. I don't remember not one point where she was having a good time or laughing or anything. Like, she breaks her toenail and wants to burn the whole daggone house down. But the reason why she wanted to throw a tantrum and bust the window this time, I think it's because Leah wouldn't forgive her for doing something. I don't remember. But they used to be really good friends, and now she wants to be friends with Leah again. But Leah doesn't want to be friends with her. So I guess that's why she wanted to throw the tantrum. But for real, Brandy, I was going to save it for you right now. You need to have some cooth. Please have some cooth right now. And, like, you're ruining it. You're ruining it for all the black people. Just stop it. You're disgusting me. Like, I'm about to pull a Wendy Williams right now and look down at the thought of you. Shout out to Wendy Williams. I'm running out of time, so I'm going to have to catch y'all next episode. Peace out. One love. Bye-bye. Oh my god, I just love this video. Like, not only do I love this video, I love you, Willow. And all I can say right now is, do it, do it, do it, do it.